I'm Michael Schiavello, and welcome to One on One with The Voice. Bibiano Fernandes, thank you for joining me, brother. We're back in Tokyo. We're back in Japan, finally. How long has it been for us, bro?
Well, I believe the last time I hit Tokyo was 8 years ago.
You exited Japan as the Dream World Champion. Yes. You re-enter today as the One Championship World Champion. What a return.
Yeah, I'm very happy to come back in Japan and like see me sick. Leave you with the Dream Champion and come back with you. One championship champion today and bring whole new view for the MMA world and back with a lot of good guys, you know what I mean? Come back with the one championship in Japan. Like, that's dream coming true for me. Dream coming true for me, you know what I mean?
Let's go way back in time. Growing up in Manaus.
In Manaus.
You scraped by on the streets with the beggars, the con artists. What do you remember about that time in your life? Very hard time.
I believe everybody, not only Bibiano Fernandes, everybody go through thing in life. We talk about the past and life. Everybody go through something in life. I was a child, my mother passed away, and I have to go to the jungle. I have to see a lot of things, the streets from Brazil. But it's good to see everything like that because I want to do better. And I see, and when I walk in Brazil, and I see people stole things, rob things, use drugs, go for many kind of direction. I say, I don't want to go that direction. And I keep it, every day I go work, I sell ice cream, I clean house, I get water for people, I go to the house for the people, I knock the door, I say, do you want to take water for you? And they say, yes. I ask the lady, how much? She said, I'll give you like $3 for each bottle, the bottle water, the gallon water, and that's the way I live my life in the past. If I go that direction, like if you go talk about the way I grew up, I was going to stay all day. He talked about the experience, about my life, grew up in Brazil, you know what I mean?
You mentioned your mother passing away. You were 7 years old at the time. Your dad couldn't raise the family on his own, so he sent you away into the Amazon jungle to live with your auntie.
Yeah.
Amazingly, you had to live off the land, right? You were hunting, you were gathering in the jungle. Tell me about that experience. I mean, a seven-year-old boy fending for himself pretty much in the Amazon jungle.
Do you know why? You are 100% true again. Because it was that time, my father don't have the money. He have seven kids with you here. But he later said, oh, go in the jungle. Like, no one in me, but my brother have to go. He only stay with my sister. And I have to go in the jungle. And when I was there, we stayed there for no water was drink for the river. Water for the river. Food we have to plant and wait to grow. We have to go fishing, you have to go hunt with my uncle. I don't hunt, I only help with the water. Every day that's my job. My job in the jungle is get water because we live in my auntie house and every day I have to go in the river, get water, put inside there, bring everything water every morning. But it's tough. It's tough. But making me who I am today, you know what I mean?
Which was tougher or more dangerous for a seven-year-old boy, living on the streets of Manaus or living in the Amazon jungle?
Both can be dangerous. The more dangerous gonna be in the jungle is the mosquito. Mosquito can, malaria mosquito, you know what I mean? Dengue mosquito, yellow fever mosquito.
You contracted malaria, right? On more than one occasion. How many times?
I have one time malaria.
One time malaria?
I don't survive for that one.
How did you survive? How do you overcome malaria living in the jungle when you don't have the medicine, you don't have hospitals? How did you get over it?
What happened, I get malaria in the jungle, and after my father have to go there, get me, take me to the city, Manaus back, but I don't know if some people can survive from malaria, but in that time, you know what I mean?
I've never known anyone who's had malaria. You're the first person I've met that suffered from malaria. So what toll does it take on your body? What does it feel like?
The fact that the malaria is, you get very, very cold. Like you burn, like you feel like tired, no blood in your system, you know what I mean? The bacteria try to survive in your river.
Into your liver?
Yeah, wow. That she try to survive that, you know what I mean? And you get so tired and you don't have no energy. You delude yourself, you know what I mean? There's a lot of things there. And I don't understand, you know what I mean? You shake, you know what I mean? But after 1 hour, everything comes normal. But every day like that, until the body gets strong, it kills the bacteria inside the body.
It's been said that no good fighter ever came from a nice smelling gym. Do you feel that the adversity that you faced early in life helped to mold you into the martial arts champion you are today?
I think so. For sure, yes. You know what I mean? Because when you mix martial art, make you humble. By the way I see a lot of things, I think I confuse a little bit because I'm a child. I get confused. I'm 14, now I'm beginning 14. I begin to get confused in life. I think everybody go through this. You get confused, you get a little angry. I did it, I get a little angry. I open my heart with you. I get a little angry when I'm 14 years old because I try to understand what the heck is going on about life. You know what I mean? Why life do this with me? Why every destroy, like why my mother have to pass away? Why I have to go live in the jungle? Why this? Why guy have to kill people? Why this? I begin to question myself. And I learned jiu-jitsu, and jiu-jitsu helped me take the anger out, away from me. And I begin to figure out life, you know, I begin to believe in God, you know what I mean? And mixed martial art, and begin to guide me, now I can be humble. But I still have the question. And I figure out, it's not about these people, it's about me. And the way I live my life and mixed martial art helped me understand who I am and humble myself. And it's not about what people do over there, what kind of reaction I want to have. And I figured out that when I'm 16, 17, and I keep it growing, and I want to grow mental, you know what I mean? I want to grow my mental strong, you know what I mean? It's okay, I was in the jungle and I'm a child, I see a lot of things, but now I'm becoming a teenager. Now I'm coming man today.
Bibiano, you're a very philosophical man. You and I have sat down on many an occasion. We've had some amazing conversations over the years about spirituality, philosophy, mysticism, and the like. In all your contemplations about life, have you come to any great realization about human experience and human existence? What's the great realization you've had?
I think for me, I every day you wake in the morning is present. First one, because you have a chance for do something good again, you know what I mean? Or you have a chance for do something better. That's my experience about life experience. Like every day I wake up in the morning, I think I can do better for yesterday. And I keep it move forward. That's the realization I have in life. For this in the past, I don't worry about the past anymore. Because the past where there is where it passed. But the realization about the life is what I go do today. What I want for tomorrow. That's I figure out right now here, you know what I mean? For sure, people come in my life, people go, you know what I mean? But for Bibiano, I experience my life. I respect people, I respect the planet. It doesn't matter where I go, I respect the people. And every time I wake up in the morning, I can do better. That's the realization I have in life.
More than half of your career bouts, amazingly, have been world title fights. How do you maintain the focus and the motivation to perform at your best when every matchup is so important?
Nobody can motivate yourself better for you. No one. Like my coach is like, I say, okay, coach, relax. I motivate myself, you know what I mean? Why this reason? Because life, back for life. Life is beauty, you know what I mean? Like the job you have today, the job I have, everybody have one job. Some people not happy with the job. For this, I understand that, motivation myself, first one. Second one, I motivation myself because I live in this planet. I have kids, I have responsibility, I have friends, I have a father, and that's motivation me, keep move forward every day. And I want to improve myself.
Have you ever had to use your martial arts for self-defense?
Oh yeah, of course, I did it.
Can you remember one time and tell me about it?
Oh yeah, for sure I can tell many times, you know what I mean? Two times it happened, right? One time I was in Brazil, played soccer, and the guy tried bully kids. He really tried bully kids in the play there. He's a little bigger, you know what I mean? And he come and bully us, play soccer. He come a very tough guy. And he pick the ball, kick the ball, you know what I mean? I say, whoa, what is this guy doing? And now he come bully us. He say, oh, nobody go play here. And we go ask the ball back, say, please give the ball. And he come in, no nice with the eyes. And I don't punch it here, I don't did nothing. I only flip it here, and I hold down and say, listen, we don't want to only play, but very polite, you know what I mean? That's one, Another time, imagine in Canada, Vancouver, right? One guy come train it to us. But the way I use mixed martial arts, that's very respectful the way I did it. Very interesting, you understand right now. And the guy's very young, very big guy, trained to my guys there, and beat the guys, getting angry, right? He get angry a little bit in the gym, because the little guy beginning to beat him. In the mat, you know what I mean? He get angry, I say, but I can mix martial arts. I come like that, I say, listen to me, you can please sit. That's mixed martial art. That's how I use my mixed martial art over here. I said, please, you can please sit. And the guy sit. And now I have a conversation with him. Listen to me. You want to come in training, you welcome come in training. But the mentality have to be behind that door there. You want to come here with mixed martial art, you welcome. You always gonna be welcome. But to come with anger, emotion, please, you can leave. That is still mixed martial art, but another way. That's how I use my mixed martial art, almost every day.
Who's the greatest MMA fighter you've ever seen?
I have two guys, right? In my time, I because I'm from Brazil, I meet one is Rickson Grace. Mm-hmm. I meet Rickson Grace, second one, Emiliano Fedor. And that's the boss guys I really like.
Hickson. What's so amazing about Rickson Gracie, first of all?
Rickson Gracie, he's the samurai, he is. He's samurai. He's the time he came in Japan, he opened this for us today. You know what I mean? The Gracie's they help build this, what I have today. And for me, Emiliano Fedor is the greatest for me.
Tell me about Fedor. What's so great about Fedor?
Oh, Fedor, he's wrestling, he's sambo, and he's jiu-jitsu, he's growing power. Oh my goodness. That guy is complete mixed martial art for me. Yeah.
Another thing I want to know, Bibiano is a unique, uncommon name. Do you know what it means or where it comes from?
I think it's very old name.
I'll tell you, I did a little bit of research. Really?
You might want to hear this one. Please, I wonder.
So I'll read off this. It comes from the Latin Vivianus, meaning he has life.
Whoa.
Now this is interesting.
Yeah.
A website I read says the characteristics of someone named Bibiano include, and this is you, perfectly describes you. You are very intuitive. You have a reservoir of inspired wisdom combined with inherited analytical ability, which could reward you through expressions of spiritual leadership. You are always looking for an opportunity to investigate the unknown, to use and show your mental abilities to find the purpose and meaning of life. How much does that sum up you to a T? That's you.
Yeah.
Your parents could not have given you a more prophetic name than Bibiano.
And can fit myself, you know what I mean? Because I always look for improvement, not only with the body, but with the spirit and the mind. You know what I mean?
Sums you up perfectly. Yeah. I thought it was a very, very apt name. Bibiano, when have you been most satisfied in your life?
Satisfies me in my life is, I have food, I do. I have a house for sleep, I do. I have good friends, I have. For this satisfies what you want to say, you know what I mean? What kind of satisfies is, I have dreams in my life, I do. But I'm satisfied my life today, like what I have. I don't want to say satisfy, I'm very thankful for everything I have. For this, I have a good job, I'm in Japan, I'm thankful. I don't think about satisfies, you know what I mean?
If you could know the absolute and total truth to just one question, what question would you ask the universe to tell you the truth about?
I think the truth is with us all the time. It's up depending to you want to see or not. You don't know, you know what I mean? If you have the courage to see the truth. The truth is all the time with us. But I don't try the question because I know the question is myself. You know what I mean? The moment I go look for the question outside, it's not the truth anymore because I lost. The truth is within me. And sometimes I stop myself because I go ask the truth. Sometimes I stop myself and I hear some people say, oh, 1,000 people die, 10 people die, and now go back the truth. And I stop a little bit thinking, I don't know the truth. You know what I mean? Maybe you go for a better place, you know what I mean? I don't know. For this, the truth is inside myself, all the time, with us. What kind of decision we want to do is our call. It's your call, you know what I mean? It's the call for the people over there.
My final question, one day, your life ends, you get to the gates of heaven, And God says to you, why should I let you in, Bibiano? What do you answer?
I don't think I go the God for that. I don't think I go in the gate for God. I don't think so. But you go say, why? Because it's very complicated. Explain this for you. Because you were in the heaven. It's a choice. We were in the heaven. If you go look, really, if you stop. God with us, he never left us. He's in us inside all the time. It's our skull. You want to see or not, again. In the heaven, it's not that. It's the heaven is here. You know what I mean? For this, I don't know, is the gate is open all the time. You know what I mean? But it's your choice, you want to go inside or not. Life is about discipline, confidence, and move forward every day. The past is the past. Now you have to keep it move forward. Doesn't matter what you're doing, mixed martial art, father, mother, and school, you know what I mean? If you want to be a lawyer one day, you'll go be a lawyer. If you want to be a doctor, you'll go be a doctor. Only pick one thing and move
forward. Stick to it.
Okay, keep it focused.
Bibiano, as always, it is an absolute pleasure, brother. Thank you for joining me today.
No problem. Thank you for having me, John.